Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Isaac Repentance. The Binding of Isaac Repentance, to give it its full legal name. I think we're going to do an Isaac. I can't remember. So, as I said before, the little piece of paper on the left that tracks your things. And there is roots, obviously, after the heart. I can't remember if you just need to beat the heart a certain amount of time. Maybe you need to beat it with other characters. Actually, yeah, let's do Samson now. I can't remember what it is that unlocks, like, the next step. So yeah, maybe we'll just do... Oh, Samson... Oh, okay, it does have... So Samson starts with... Bloodlust? I think it's called. And basically, like, it's a really good item and you can get some really good synergies with it. Excuse me for burping. What it does is when you get hit in a room, it raises your... I don't really want the magnetized tears. No, I don't want that. I'm gonna come back when I've got some money to reroll that. Yeah, so what it does is it increases your damage for that room. So if you can synergize that with something that makes you sort of take damage, which there are a few items, it can work out really, really well. But it also means that if you're taking damage, you're also getting stronger, which is obviously a positive thing. Ooh, piercing tears. Yeah, let's go for that. Piercing shots is good. So yeah, this is, I quite like this character. Oh, that's fun. Petrified poop is really handy. So 50% chance to get drops from poop. Oh, I had to tend to drop that. Mr. Mega! Okay, we need to be able to get into you. Okay, well, let's see what we get from our poops now that we've got petrified poop. So poops always have a chance to like drop something, but when you've got petrified poop, it obviously increases it to 50%, which is very nice. The butter bean has appeared in the basement as well. If we get a few hearts, I will go and play, we got a trush. I'm going to unlock this chest and I will also go and play. Ooh, what are you? Plus one damage spawns a random rune or soul stone. Fun. Didn't spawn a rune though. Okay. Okay, cool. Didn't give us much. I wonder if some of these descriptions are maybe slightly out of date or if they don't apply yet because, do you know what it'll be? I probably haven't unlocked runes yet. Excuse me, that's what it'll be. I've not actually unlocked the runes yet. That makes sense. I do want to check to see what this other room is. Spent quite a lot of time here, just on floor one, but just want to see what's going on. Want to see what they're up to. Oh, okay, that's what's happening. Cool, okay. I think I'm happy to go. You know, I think I was wrong about the Bloody Lust. It's not just for the room, it's for the whole floor. You see how my guy is a slightly darker shade of pink? Oh. I think it's actually for the full floor. So that means that, you know, it's... You've got more reason to play like blood banks and stuff like that. one fall is very good. Let's see what our damage goes down to. Yeah, so it went down to 5.19. So that's, yeah, okay, so that's fun. Excuse me. So anywhere that I can lose damage. Loot. Anywhere that I can damage myself, but like get hearts back and stuff is good. There is a tinta drop there. I'm not going to take that just now though, because if I want to play the room, the spikes on the floor, don't know its name, spiky room, I don't want to have where it hearts it's going to take away. Oh nice, now golden key, it's into all the rooms for free, so that's cool. Does the spiky room affect your devil deal chance? I don't think so. There's only one way to find out. Yes, I am going to pop all of these poops. Let's go play it and then we'll see. It doesn't. Okay, that's good to know. Cool. So now I'm going to take that, I'm going to take these hearts. I could have sort of went back and played it more and... Virgo, taking damage can make Isaac temporarily invisible. It also said something about pills, didn't it? I didn't read it. Yay! Something about making pills better or something. I'm gonna buy that and then I'm gonna buy the... Oh, look at my little pink bowl! That's so cute. Aww. That's another tinted drop there. This has been a very good floor, actually. Very generous. I kept thinking about, like, all today I was thinking about playing this. Because this used to be my go-to game, right? This used to be the game that I, like, would play at least once per day. You know, that way, like, I would normally do the, like, the daily challenges, when I wasn't, like, you know, obviously, like, trying to get the unlocks and stuff like that. This is, like, my comfort game. And, like, Gus always laughs at that. And I can see why, because it's not a very comforting game. You know, it's not like, you know, Stardew or Animal Crossing or anything like that. But I don't know what it is about this game. But because it, even though it gets hard and frustrating and everything, there's just something so satisfying about the gameplay loop. What does that do? Lazy Worm, zero. Put your shot speed down. Okay, I don't want that. Well, no, that's not good at all. Yeah, so this is like my comfort game. Or used to be at least. And I've not played it like that for two golden keys and one floor. Okay. I've not played it in that way for a long, long time, so it's kinda nice to be back here. Judgment. Okay. I'm gonna hold on to you. No, you might be useful later. It's kind of nice. It's like back with an old friend kind of thing. It's really... I know that sounds very over the top for not just a video game, but like, you know, a sort of a basic roguelike that's got like no... It does have a storyline, you know, no sort of deep storyline or whatever. But this is just, yeah. This was the game that I just like to put on every day and just, you know, Actually, Isaac was the first thing that I streamed. So, oh, what are you? Glass eye, damage and luck. Nice. Let me just see what these are and then I'll continue that train of thought. Now, I normally like fear shot. Let's just double check. It's going to be good to me. Plus one damage. It's called dark matter. 33% chance to shoot fear tears. Fear tears? Yeah, so ages ago, when I was playing Isaac all the time, the PlayStation has like a sort of inbuilt Twitch thing, right? So you can just stream from the PlayStation. Rooms looking okay. Yeah, they're looking okay. I don't have any keys to give you, sorry. And yeah, so the first thing that I actually streamed was this. I had no camera, because I had no camera like I could hook up to the PlayStation. I was talking. And I hadn't, you know, I'd done nothing. I had like no socials or anything like that. I was just like, you know. I just gave it a go, and I didn't do it for long. But technically this was the first thing that I ever streamed. So yeah, I've definitely come sort of full circle. Entering a new floor spawns up to 4 uncollected pickups from the previous floor. Excuse me, I'm going to take that because the poop doesn't sort of stops appearing as often the lower down you go. That was a nice payout. So the poop is going to be less and less useful, whereas getting pickups I can get before. Very nice. I really just want it. No. Okay. I could do it with some more health. That is for sure. Have I missed it? Yeah, I've not had the item room or anything yet. I was thinking it was a bit short. So yeah, this is the first thing that I streamed, and then I only did that a couple of times, and then I didn't really bother with it. It wasn't until the pandemic that I thought about doing it again. The thing that made me start streaming was Metal Gear Solid 2 was available on the PC for the first time. Right. Flush. Turns all non-boss enemies into poop. Instantly kills poop enemies and bosses. Extinguishes fireplaces and fills the room with water. Turns lava pits into walkable ground. Oh, okay. That's... yeah. Turns all non... Wait. If I take this, then I'd want my poop guy back, right? I'd want my poop trinket back if I take that. That seems really good, though. Interesting. Yeah, so Metal Gear Solid 2. Which... let's say one of my favourite games, and the only way you could play it was on either the PlayStation 2 or the PlayStation 3, and then it got released onto the PC. And I just remember thinking, like, if there was anything I would want to share with the world. But you didn't get turned to poo, did you? Probably because he wasn't open. If there was any game I wanted to sort of share with the world, it would be Metal Gear. You know, now that it's like a rare game that no one knows. Excuse me. Diplopia. Oh yeah! Single use item, so I don't think I want it. Not just now. I think I might just do a little bit of a donation. Please take me down to 15. Yeah, I was like, if there was any game that I wanted to sort of share with the world, it would be Metal Gear. Especially Metal Gear Solid 2, because it's an old game now. You know, it was made in like 2001. Or it came out in 2001. You know, a lot of people have sort of heard about Metal Gear, but have maybe not seen it or played it themselves. Let me get that back. I'm just gonna blow you up for the fun of it. Yay! Oh, that was nice actually. That worked out really well. So yeah, so that was the first... That was the first thing that I streamed. So I got Metal Gear Solid 2 on PC. That was fun! I also, like, I hadn't really been part of any communities or anything like that. I just sort of... just kind of went for it. But it was nice. There was... people that turned up and everything, you know, it was good. And then just kind of went from there. I always forget that playing this in the PlayStation, it gives me like a sore on my finger. I think it's because of the way I like hold it there. It's like I kind of push it. I shouldn't do that, but it's just kind of just become habit. But yeah, I was talking to a friend today about the whole streaming thing, because they're also a streamer, and just sort of wondering out loud, you know, if I'm gonna go back, kind of thing. It's not a big deal, like, you know, like I streamed on like, did like a wee DJ set on Christmas Eve and stuff. But I think it was just, I think Twitch is, oh, I should have played this for one more time, but anyway. Twitch is a hard place to exist. They don't make it easy for you. Yeah, I'm just gonna... well, actually, this would be more useful because I can damage myself then, which means I can then have more damage. So it makes more sense for me to take this one. Because then whenever I get red hearts, I can just use that and that'll damage me and put my damage up. Orphan socks, meaning to creep and floor spikes. Ooh, nice. That's really handy actually, because I'm really bad at walking over spikes. So having that security is really good. Who's in here? No one? No one. No one's in here. What's with these weird empty rooms? The magician. I'm going to keep judgment, although I might not need it as much now. Fine. Oh! Yay! The stars are calling. Planetarium. That's a new thing for me. Okay. I got two judgments. Hey. Come on, give me something. Come on. I like that you can still hit him when you've got a shield on. You can kind of cheat it a little bit. Come on! Yay! Synthol was good. What else did I get? Death. So yeah, that's why I'm holding on to judgment. for that ability to get my damage up. I don't really need it now. I should probably just trade it away for another card that I can actually use. That would make more sense. I can hear the wind picking up outside. Isn't it weird though that like when you've got storms and stuff, they seem to get worse at night time? Is that like a meteorological reason for that? Like because the sun's not out? It is weird though. There must be a reason for it. Why? I don't know why I stood there. I knew that was going to hit me. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on! Stop trying to hit me and hit me. Gonna clear all the poop. Or all the lies in the hoops. Alright, so I've reached the maximum damage it seems with using that right now. So I've got about 14.21 damage. That's pretty good. Beelzebub! Yeah! My friend. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use Judgment just now. And see if we can get something else out of him. That would be very nice actually. Come on. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Two diamonds. Ooh, two diamonds doubles our money. That's nice. Can I hit you with a unicorn? Okay, little horn's fun as well. Nice. Big brother is watching. It's getting really windy out there. Ooh. The windows are whistling away. I don't want that, so I'm gonna, since I've got an excess of money, I'm gonna go and donate some and see how jammed myself right in there. Lovely. See how high we can get it before it stops. Woo! Nice. Oh, no, well, I don't want poop anymore, do I? Because I don't have the poop thing. What does red patch do again? Taking damage has a 20% chance to grant plus 1.8 damage for the room. That might take me over the cap. Don't know if it will, but it might. We'll see. Okay, where's our boss? It's over here. I'm gonna clean up and all the lies. I might as well play this and see what I get out of it. I'm not going to spend all 61 coins, don't worry, because that would take a while. But I'll play it for a wee bit, see what we get out of it. To make a citizen out of you. It's been, it's really fun, like, having a... So I've got a teenage son, and it's really, really fun when they're like into the same music and stuff as you. Because, you know, I was like expecting them to rebel, but it's like, no, he's just ended up having like the best taste. It's great. We just like listen to music, you know, like in the car, and we can just like sing along together. So, missing page 2, taking damage down to 1. I don't know if the microphone's picking that up, but my windows are singing. Taking damage down to 1 heart damages all enemies in the room. It's not really worth it, is it? No, because I only get 1 black heart out of it, so it's not worth it. No, thank you. I would not like your deal. Thanks, but no thanks. Thanks, but no thanks. Can I blow up that? Will it blow up? Nope, okay. Well, I can always play it, actually. Will you blow up? Oh no, I can, oh no, that takes your spirit hearts, you silly Billy. Let's see what we get out of this. Oh, okay. It blew up anyway. I think it must have spawned a troll bomb. I just didn't notice. Ah. I really hate those guys in those tiny rooms. It is not fun. I've got mom's underwear. Lovely stuff. I've got 2 diamonds. Which is nice because that doubles your... What was your money? Oh, I'm gonna be rich. Toxic Shock's really good. Oof. Really good items this run. But it basically poisons the enemies, which some enemies it'll kill just like outright. That might be a secret room. Okay, never mind. Yeah, so you see there how it just like killed that instantly. That might be a secret room. Okay, I give up. Can't always get it right, you know. What have we got here? The Emperor. So let's take 2 diamonds. It takes us up to 86 coins. Very nice. Oh, nearly. Did you see that? Did you see that? Reverse at the very last minute. Hey, come on. Come on. Down here. Down here. There you go. Cool. I didn't even pick up the bomb. Come on. There you go. Cool. Right. Oh. Mom's box spawns a random trinket while held plus 1 luck. Double trinket effects. Don't really want it. I've got all the money, but I don't really want it, so that's fine. We could probably get through this a lot faster now with this shock. Not that we've been slow, but I've been sort of like, you know, because I was playing the machines and stuff like that. When you start to get really strategic and min-maxy with Isaac, it can take a long time. There is a boss rush if you can kill Mom in under. It's either 20 minutes. Little larva. What does little larva do? Destroy and poop spawns 1 blue fly. Yeah, I think I'll take that rather than the other one. Yeah, so there's... It's either 20 minutes or 30 minutes. If you kill Mom before then, there's a boss rush. Which is something I will be looking to do because it's... something you want to obviously do and get unlocked and all that, but right now I'm still just getting into the groove. Spawns a pushable TNT barrel. Nah, I'm not interested in that. I will do that though. Get into the groove, oh, you got to prove your love to me. Also had some really sort of fun news earlier. Right, sorry, I'm thinking now. I want to play that at least a couple of times. I have a family member who lives overseas who's coming to visit. And very soon, actually, in like a few weeks. Well, that's nice. I'm looking forward to that. Also mean that I've been in an airport, right? More times in the last 2 years than I have in basically all my life. Been really weird. I definitely think it's been like the sort of pre-COVID effect, you know, of just like wanting to get out and wanting to explore. Wait, what does March Stick do again? 100% chance for the room clear reward to be a bomb. Yeah, I'll keep this one. Because we went to Japan at the start of last year, and that was definitely a bit of a kind of when sort of COVID happened. It was like, well, that's, yeah, I'm gonna do that. It's like, you don't know, do you know, like, if this is ever gonna happen again. So I think I know that that's why we took the chance to just go, because it kind of made you realize that sometimes, you know, you shouldn't wait for things. Like, if you can, you know, if you can do something, then you should probably just do it. But yeah, because last year I went to Japan, then my friend from America visited, and then I also was in Edinburgh with, sorry, trying to tell stories while you're like, also reading things is really hard. I don't know how people do it. Yeah, and then B. Dolan came over to do the Fringe, so I picked him up at the airport as well. I'm not bothered about either of these, I think. No, I'm not bothered. So yeah, I ended up being in the airport a lot. And I hadn't been abroad before COVID. It'd been a good few years since I'd like really been abroad. It was kind of funny just to like be in the airport all the time, you know? Right, I need to remember that the blood bank, it takes one heart because I'm... So when you get further down to these levels, enemies that would have normally hit you for half a heart now hit you for a whole heart. So you have to be careful with that. And just be kind of mindful of it. Remember I was talking about mindfulness. Just be, your eyes are... Your eyes are not meant to be there. That is not where your eyes are meant to be. Definitely not. Definitely not. Bob's Rotten Head, I'm not going to take, but I think if you pick it up, it kind of counts. I don't know if there's any unlocks for, like, you know, having touched all the items or whatever, but just in case. I think it's better just to touch all the items. loads of pills. I don't know what they are, that's fine. Is this an Isaac run? It is, isn't it? Yeah, okay. I can't remember because looking at the character tells me. No! It's not, is it? The Samson? Yes, it's Samson. Because it started with the, oh, that's coins now, not keys. Oh, fun. Okay. Oh, I can go over the spikes as well. Oh, nice! Whee! I think I've got the sneezy. can feel it. I can feel it brewing behind my eyes. It's threatening. It's threatening to just pop out at any second. It's have you ever been edged by a sneeze before? Because that's exactly what's happening right now, and it's really annoying. Oh. I need to go and stare at some light. I wonder if I stare at my ring light. No, I don't think it's the right light. See, by the way, see if you ever need to sneeze. Don't sniff pepper. It is horrendous. Do not recommend. Okay, so I'm not getting any more. Right, that's me got my damage up maximum now though, so that's nice. Yeah, I've done it like a few times where like you really need to sneeze. So you sniff pepper and it's horrible. Really, really, really horrible. I'd rather be edged by a sneeze than do that. But sometimes looking at... Ooh, nice. Eye drops. Cool, yeah. Sometimes looking at bright light. Ooh, there's a few good things here. A few good things. Rotten baby's good because it gives you flies. And pentagram's good. Because it puts up your devil angel room chance and gives you damage. Now what are you? Too spooky, fears enemies in a small radius around Isaac. Okay, I'm not going to take you because you're going to use up too many of my hearts. But that's good to know because I wasn't exactly sure what that item did when I was looking at it before. Now we know. Alright, let's see what's in the library. Well, it's not library, but... So we're looking pretty good here. This, the only frustrating thing about sort of going back and playing this is that... Oh... Oh shit! Okay, now I just did something weird there. But I'm gonna go for it. Because this might be the only... So, very quickly, Joker takes you to the devil or angel room. This Joker has taken me to the devil room. And this is... Oh, but if I do this... So this is gonna take me lower. Now, I don't know if we're quite at the sequence yet where we can start to go even lower, because you normally need to get a certain item before, like a Polaroid. So I might go down... If I go down here, I might not be able to go to the boss. But if I don't go down here, I might not get a chance later. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. I know this might sound like absolute like nonsense. It's kind of hard to explain, but once I've done the hello. Itchy nose. Ooh, hey. When I've got the shield on, I can just play them all. Nice. Okay. Oh, excuse me. No, I'm going to take the strength card, actually. It's really hard to explain that predicament that I had there. I'll hopefully be able to explain it when we get to the next boss bit. I probably didn't explain it well, and it probably sounded incredibly confusing. But trust me, there is logic. In thinking. I'm just not sure if it's hard logic to explain if you've never seen the game before. If you are watching, not to be one of those YouTubers, but given it, if you enjoy this video, giving it a wee like thumbs up does help. Because obviously the more people, you can force to see your videos, the better. But you know what I mean. But also let me know if you have, I'm so sure that was a secret room. Let me know if you've played Isaac, or if you're curious about playing it, or if you just like watching it. I'm curious to know like what other people's experience with this game is, especially because so the first Isaac, the very, very first Isaac, which was just the Binding of Isaac, was a Flash game. So that might give you a bit of an idea of how sort of old this game actually is. And then, as I said before, it got updates and DLCs and that kind of thing. And it's ended up the game that you see before you. I tried to play two strength cards, lovely. I could play you. No, don't want to do that. I tried to play the original Isaac after having played. Well, the crystal ball can be quite good. I think this is more useful for me though. Yeah, and it was, I mean, obviously it was a great game. This is the original Isaac. It was a great game for the time. No, I'm not going to be able to go down to thingy, am I? Maybe the devil room will open because it's already open. We'll see. We'll see. Okay. Oh, that's a shame. So if I'd went down that hole that was in the devil room, that would have taken me to Shoal, I think. But which is something you can get to after this room, but only after you've done certain things. I can't remember what. I edited a little bit out there because this game does deal with some triggering subjects. I think it deals with them in a very interesting way, and you could talk about the sort of lore and the story and everything that goes into Isaac for a long time. But that last scene was maybe a bit too much, so I've just edited it out there. Anyway, let me see. Okay, sometimes these little cards give you an indication as well as to what's going on. I wonder if the 3x is above it. I don't know. Anyway, look, we've got Samson. So Samson, Cain, and Isaac have both got the heart completed. So making progress. I'm gonna leave that here for today. I'll hopefully have another Isaac video for you in 2 days. Like and subscribe. Okay. I'll catch you later. Bye bye.